Before we can release this component, we need to define some extra metadata in our composer file. Once we're done, we will have a code base that is ready to submit to Packagist, which is the default repository for Composer. This makes your package available to the entire PHP community. Let's have a look at how that works. So, this is the same code base we've been working on for the stage so far. We have a composer JSON, which so far only has the very basics in there. We have the autoloading section, which explains how our code is autoloaded. We have two dev dependencies, and nothing else. Before we can submit this to Packagist, we have to add more information. One such piece of information is the name. This is very important. This could be your company name, your last name, or even a nickname, but it should be something unique. So we're going to call it Treehouse. This first part is the vendor name, and then the actual name of the package itself comes after the slash, and we're going to call this example. Try and keep this underscore and try and keep it as simple as possible because people have to type this. So if it's very complicated, people will forget or won't find it. And of course, put a comma at the end to make sure it's valid JSON. Next, we want to add a description. This can be anything you want. So this is an example package. Sounds about right. Next, this is optional, but it's very useful. We can add an array of keywords. So add keywords, JSON array, comma at the end. And then these are just arbitrary strings. They don't have to be specific words, but try and keep them simple and alphanumeric. So we'll call it example, treehouse, squirrel. And that's it. Next, we should add a license. It's a pretty good idea if you have open source code to license it so people know what they can do with it, whether they can fork it, whether they can modify it, etc. So there are various options here. You could have MIT, BSD, GPL, or a whole bunch of other ones, but I like the MIT license. Now this next part's a little bit complicated, but it's just JSON, so it's not too crazy. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make an author, and we're gonna create an array using square brackets. The reason it's an array is because we can have multiple objects in here, which are all different authors. So we'll have an object here, and each author can have four different properties. They can have name, and that, of course, is Phil Sturgeon. They can have an email, phil@example.org. It's not my real address. They can optionally have a home page, which could be their blog or their GitHub profile, or even a company address. And finally, I have a role, and the role is developer. No comma on the last one, or it won't be valid. Finally, it's a good idea to add a require section. This is where you'll place a list of your dependencies for the package to run. Not things like dev dependencies that only are useful while we're developing, but actually required to run. So you can name other packages in here. So if you wanted to use Buzz, which we saw in an earlier example, or Monologue, you'd name those here. But we're going to do a special requirement, which is PHP. This isn't a package, obviously. This is a special requirement. And what we can do here is do greater than or equal to 5.4. Now, what this will do is it will let any developer that tries to install our package on 5.3 or less, they won't be able to install this package. They need 5.4 to run this, and without it, they can't have it. With all of that done, we want to make sure that this actually works. The way we do that is by typing composer validate. So here it says the property author is not defined and the definition does not allow additional properties. I think I might have made a slight mistake here. Go up to author. I think that's meant to be authors. Perfect, we have a valid JSON file.
That does it for our composer.json walkthrough. There is a little bit more work for you to do to get this onto Packagist, but most of that is simply setting up a public Git or Mercurial repository and going to the Submit to Packages link below this video. The hardest part has been done. You now have a package with autoloaded namespace code using a handful of well-known standards. This, combined with general PHP object-oriented knowledge, means you can now make some amazing code and distribute it to the entire rest of the community. The only thing left, once you have done all of that, is to start using semantic versioning. This will help you release a few development builds and then march towards version 1.